Hello, and in this video I'll show you exactly what the sheet does for each tab without going into the detail on how to flip or how to merge. So the first tab we're going to look at is the individual margins tab, and this just looks at individual items and what the current margin for that item is. It gives you the profit per item, the return on investment, and the full buy limit profit, which is just the amount you would make if you bought and sold a full buy limit of that individual item. And this is pre-populated with a lot of items that are good for flipping to start with, and then some of the more higher end items at the end as well, which you can use as well. So the next tab is the item creation tab. So this just goes into creating sets from items or boots from like the two ingredient parts. So guardian boots, dwarf cannon set, etc. And it gives you the profit that you would make on these. Sometimes they're good, sometimes they're not so good, and you can use it to make a bit of profit here and there. The other thing you can do, so there's two, there's an item creation and an armor sets. So this is like creating the items. And the armor sets is creating the armor sets. So that would be, you would buy the individual obsidian helmet, plate body, and plate legs. And then you would create the armor set and you would sell the armor set. There's an insta buy sell. So this is if you buy the items instantly and then sell it instantly, you would still make profit. However often you'll lose the column L. So this is if you like buy the items slowly and sell them slowly, or is this if you do it instantly? We also have the same for barrows, which is the same for creating barrow sets. So that's just buying the parts and creating the armor set. Zora, so this is buying the serpentine visage and creating the serpentine helm. It also has like the sort of creating Zora scales from the item, so this is where you buy the item and then break it to create the scales, and that shows you how much profit you would or indeed wouldn't make from there. Next we have potions. So this is buying the 3-dose potion and selling the 4-dose potion. Some net profit, some don't. Note, Sanfu Serum will always tell you that there's a lot of profit, but not very many are traded, so it's unlikely that you'll hit very many of these, so just bear that in mind. The ones that would typically net you money would be like Super Restores and Brews, if they're making money. So Restores are making a little bit at the moment, but others are not. Next is Saplings. So this is where you buy the seed and you create the sapling and sell the sapling. So this can net you some money as well. There are two columns again. This is the Insta Buy and Sell column. So this is where you buy it instantly, and this is where you buy it slowly, sell it slowly, which will typically net you quite a lot more profit. So that about covers up what the sheet does. If there are any questions, feel free to reach out and let me know in the comments. Yeah, hope it was helpful.